Thank you for watching continuing coverage from round three of Rocky Top Open 2023. This round featured Hendo with Swoops I Did It Again, four Black Sun Enforcers with a Magdette, the Vigo, the Recon Intel, and Frag Grenades, two Black Suns with a Magdette and Frag Grenades, three Swoop Box, and an AA-5 speeder truck with a raiding party leader and a refurbished Gonk Droid. Adam S., I'm just here for the memes. Three Rebel strike teams with a Saboteurs, X-34 land speeder with a Hotshot, the A-300 gunner, the unstable R-5, and the Mark 1, the AA-5 speeder truck with Shriv, backworld medic, unstable R-5, and the Gonk and the quad laser cannon, Boba Fett with Hunter, Seize the Initiative, Flame Projector and E-Stems, Fleet Troopers with a Scattergun and an Astromech Droid, two Rebel Veterans with a CMO-93 and two Mark II Medium Blasters.
Alright. I got a small glitch or two that I need to fix today. Adam Slaver. Operative Boba. Fleet with scattergun and R5. Rebel Vets with a heavy x2. Two Mark IIs. Three rounds of a Proton Charge Saboteur Strike Team. X-34 Land Speeder with a Hotshot Pilot, A-300 Rifle Gunner, the Unstable R-5 Astromech, and a Mark II Medium Blaster. AA-5 Speeder Truck with Shriv, Backworld Medic, Unstable R-5, and the Quad Laser Cannon. Built to blow stuff up, not built to live. And let's take a quick look over here for Hendo and his list. It's a list that he likes to call Swoops, I Did It Again. And we've got 1, 2, 3, 4 units of Black Suns with a Magdet Enforcer, the Vigo, Recon Intel, and Frag Grenades, and 2 more squads with just the Magdet and Frags, 3 Swoop Box, and a Speeder Truck with a Raiding Party Leader and refurbished Gonk Droid. I guess we're shipping stuff that way and dealing out suppression. Definitely don't want to get up close and personal with that list, as it looks like it could rip most things apart with all the impact it's got due to the impact and surge crit with grenades. Those are some very dangerous dice pulls. Red versus black, white. I think I'd almost rather have the red every round. So, right, back to the table. We've got command cards down, round one. Window, making a few measurements, and it's standing orders versus rule with respect. Checking a few things here. See what. So Hendo looking to see what he can get here. Might be getting ready to try some kind of weird. Passing out aim tokens for all the independent. Couple of surges. And our key points is ATSD head. Tree over here by the landing pad. And the turret
blink out real fast?
Just behind the sweet box. First dice throw of the game. See what we got here. Alright. Alright. So. Three going into the SAP squad. Only loses a dude. So Hendo striking first on first blood. Adam going to the bag, pulls a token. See what he got here. All right, quick line of sight check there to see who would it, to see who does and who don't. And I do want to figure out why I keep getting the random reboots here, guys. I do apologize. First round of dice, whole bunch of paint, and looks like a couple of saves. Quick measuring here. Old combat math. Another unit of Black Sun stepping up to poke their head out. We'll see if he can't. Hendo grabs a fistful of dice. See a bunch of whites and a bunch of reds. Hit. Three hits and a crit. Surge to convert later. Reroll. Adds three more to the pool. So looks like seven coming in. Nope, four. And the first saboteur unit is off the board. Brett walking around passing out some more prize support for everybody. Alright, get another dice pool ready here. See where it's going. And the kill count for Adam is not looking good. Astromech's fleets are down. Two units of stabs are down. And Hendo is down. Looks like five models out of a. There's a lone unit leader left for that squad. Boba and the Land Speeder. And this has been a very bloody and brutal game for turn one. Double move on the back. Double move dodge for the unit of bikes moving up the battlefield. Adam drawing a token. Core unit. Looks like it's going to be a Mark II blaster. And I think he's going to try and finish off Swoop Bike. Just out of range. Move up a vet squad with a 093 heavy and try and finish off Swoop Bike. This is what it looks like here. Reposition move from the bus. A little final finagling. And the bus takes a standby, which won't go away if it's shot. And bringing the other unit of box up. It looks like double move. Now the third SAB squad's over here on the home objective for Adam. By this little mini landing pad. If you're still hanging out with us today from Rocky Top, glad to have you with us. Adam's making a few measurements with the bus. And it looks like we're getting ready to throw a bunch of dice at a bunch of minis here. Bus shot looked like it was pretty good. So three coming in after cover. Picked up a couple models there. Looks like you picked two up out of that squad.
Thank you.
Hendo Dodge standbys on the unit that's on his objective. And Lance Peter making an appearance here. And I unfortunately don't expect it to live too long. There's enough impact on the other side of that board. And magdeck grenades that it may not survive. And no, let's do a little bit of quick math here. I do think the one squad's embarked. So Hendo has lost 70 points. And Adam is Sorry about that, guys. Thanks, Wee Bear. I had stepped around to, I don't know what happened right there, guys. Tomorrow will be better, I promise. We're going into round two. Roll off. Adam gets it. Floyd and Boba, new Boba's one pip. Tokens for Adam, hit the land speeder, and Boba. And land speeder moves up. Getting ready to take a shot here.
My two bikes are up and just take off.
Adam trying to remove this land speeder from the battlefield a little bit early. It's only he realizes what's probably going to happen, and it was just trying to play the game two turns ahead. Sweet box with it. Pulled the order there. Compulsory move out of the speeders. And then they're going to take a pop shot at Bubba in the open. I mean, I don't know that two red, two white's exactly a pop shot. Or two red, two black. Looks like three coming in. And Bubba saves two, takes one. And then after their shot, they're going to compulsory away. Run away. Uh-oh. I just happened to watch it as it come across the floor.
That's not suppressive, right? All right, so that was my turn.
So as far as points destroyed go, it's been tightened up a little bit. Actually, a lot. Hendo has lost a full unit of Black Suns with the Big O. The Big O. And the Magdette. And a full unit of Box. And he's lost a couple other models here and there. Bringing the other unit of swoops around. Alright, bus making an appearance here. Land speeder hasn't bid it yet, but very well may by the end of the turn. Bus takes a move standby. Where just about anything that Adam does will trigger the standby. And suppression roll gets one or two off of it. Ooh. Let's see here. I see three crits. That was a beautiful roll. fistful of dice here. Coming in. And Land Speeder has bit the dust. So as it stands, I think that hurts even more for Adam here because he's down. Let's see here, 71, 114, 157, 258 down right now for Adam and Hendo. For 159. So there's about 100 and about 98 points difference between the two right now. Couple of hits there. Let's see here. Crit, hit. Moves a single surge aside for a possible later conversion. Spins the aim, adds two more to that. 5 coming in. And saves two blanks and a surge. I believe that is 2 more wounds on Boba. Yep, Boba at 4. So I think he's got 1 more left. Chad, if you could, give us a share. We're nearing the halfway point in this round. And tell you what, somebody who's commented in chat today at some point in time, I'm going to reach out to you for a shipping address as I have a little stream prize to send out. We'll figure out who gets it today at the end of the stream. If you want in on it, give us a... Let us know you're still watching in the chat. Zazar, I appreciate you hanging out with us today. Death and destruction on this board. Lots. Hendover passes the activation to the Black Suns in the bus. As we all know, the Black Suns in the bus go pew, 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 pew. Alright. A couple of Rebel Vets going off to finish off the one speeder there. Trying to finish off the lone speeder back there. And blanks 5 of 5 for a dead speeder bike. They was just embarked on the bus. So that does change things by 71 points on for Adam, because that's about 183 or so left for him. We're currently dead. Right. Occasionally I paint while I stream. Sometimes I don't. Two coming in. Looks like it was two wounds that went out. Alright. Nearing end of the round here. It's been an absolute blast hanging out with everybody today. Alright, quick judge call there. Resolving issues. Enjoys what we're doing today. I do apologize about the loud banging noises. There's some kind of game going on upstairs where they do that.
4 coming in.
And is this going to be the end of Boba? 1, 2, 3, 4. And Boba is dead. So Adam's looking a little thin here. Hendo still has a unit of Black Suns and buses. Hive coming in. And Hendo has lost another unit of box here. So he's down to one squad, where he's no box left. He's got a 5-man squad, a 3-man squad, a squad and a bus. And the squad back here on the objective, capping it. Now, if Hendo wants to move the squad on the objective up and retreat the other squad, it might make a difference on turn 6. Hendo's currently using the bus as a blocker of sorts. Looks like we're going to turn 4 here. Oop. Adam removing the Boba flamethrower card from his command hand. Hendo using the shield. Core unit. Orange squad. Now, looks like he's going to take a move action with it. Might have changed. If he did, he moved back. What happened there? Move back out of line of sight. So, Adam moving a Rebel Vet Squad out, taking a pot shot at the bus. One coming in. Both shields down on the bus. raiding party leader, pivot, and a standby. Fleet. Repair bus. Bus to bus shop. Nope, fleet to bus shop. Fleet to the shotgun. Looks like two into the bus. Sun's eject. Looks like he has declined the speed one move from the ejection. So it's key positions on Warwary with advanced positions. Biggin. Hey, glad to see that we're moving the old viewer count up a little bit more here. Let's see here. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 8's going into something here. Two minis lost on the exchange. Two coming in, two blocks. We got a Rebel Vet Squad going. Loser Mini. So the Ejecto Squad down a Mini to suppression. Samba, looks like he's going to go for a run over here. Red dice doing white dice, doing red dice things. Spend a shield on the bus. So Biggin, the list in this one is triple rebel sab, land speeder, bus, versus Hendo Oops All Swoops. It's three swoops, a bus, and a bunch of Black Suns with grenades. Literally explosions everywhere on this battlefield. Going into turn four. And this game keeps getting quicker and quicker as we go. It's a real interesting game so far. Hendo's now losing a lot of models and not getting much in exchange for them. I'm not sure if it's a thing of positioning to where he's just left some stuff out where he shouldn't have, or if he got too aggressive early. Yeah, I've seen some interesting sleeves today on stream for sure. I've seen some of the Legion Discord ones. I've seen the 5280 sleeves. Several of the FFG sleeves roaming around here today. I don't know if I'm going to get to announce the stream game for tomorrow tonight before I go. And don't forget, Invader League signups start in June. Based on fingers left, Adam. Based on current positioning, I'd probably give it to Adam either way at this moment. Unless some dice take a turn for the worse here in the near future. Hendo missing a rally roll. Yeah, things very well can change quickly. On the Black Suns, man, it's hard to say. Black Suns throwing some dice at what appears to be a Rebel vet or two. Hit. Rerolls three. Another hit added to the pile. White dice doing white dice things. And another crit. So it looks like seven. Down to two. That six pack looks like it picked up the entire squad. There's that how things can change quickly, Biggin. Definitely how things change. Thank each and every one of you that's hung out with us today. All right, Adam with a Mark II dice pull here. Oh, there's a couple of white dice in there. One, two, three. Yep, save three, lose one. That's how Hendo's. That's where Hendo is coming undone. He's just losing one mini at a time. But Invader League signups on the third week of June. With about a month later, first round will be starting. And you can go to InvaderLeague.com when signups open to join in on all the fun. Want to hang out and join us on the 82nd Legion Discord? Get that taken care of for you as well. Alright. Whole bunch of dice here. Surge. Yeah, because the lighting in here keeps changing a little bit as the day goes on. Eh, if he's watching from a cell phone, he may not be able to read how I've got it all set up, because I try to maximize table space versus all the add-ons here. Both players control their main objective, and Hendo has a couple units that can make a dive for it that don't have to double move to get there. And time is running out. A little measuring or two. Set it up to where looks like some blue-black suns coming up and over Ostrich air. Trying to keep hitting. Slightly doing a slightly better positioning on Blackson's by the bus rally. Trying to see what they have. Range move. They have a name token. Looks like they're going to try and get a hold of another Mark II here. No aim token. Two to getting an order. The last of that Rebel Vet squad is gone. So let's do the key positions. One's right here where these two models are by the tree and this landing pad, the AT-ST head, and the Hoth cannon down there. Well, up in the top left. Yeah, those vets have been baller on their saves. But every time they save good, they crash hard. Alright. Bomb squad, special forces. I don't think Hendo pushes towards that. I believe Hendo. Okay. So if this is me. Hendo lost the squad in that exchange. Keep the other two squads hidden for two more turns. There's a unit of fleets. Backing the bus up. Maybe so if Adam moves anything over the objective, he can fly back over it and relocate anything and everything that is there. So the two units of Black Suns behind the AT-ST body and the AA-5 are probably I think Hendo's got a real chance at it here. I know stream can't hear it, but I keep hearing some sonic noises go off over and over and over and over again. Still have 54 active players on the day. Looks like we've had a bus come off its base. So we'll just move a base and then reset the bus. The bus moves up. It looks like it could.
Yeah,
activating a standby, crit fishing. Two aim tokens on this shot. There's a crit. One going into the bus. Bus saves it. So with that move, Adam is in control of the center point. Still plenty of places to get minis on top of it. Looks like a unit of Black Suns are going to move up here. ...65 minutes left in the round. Ooh boy, a whole bunch of paint on those dice. Two crits, three crits with surge crit. Aim token. Nope. Which, if those are magnets, I believe. Blast and impact three. So Rebel Vet looks like a lone guy making a mad dash to the center. And Fleet Troopers are officially gone. Let's do a quick model count to see what's left on this board. Alright, we got a unit of Sabs, a Mark II, two Mark IIs, and a Rebel Vet, and a bus for Adam. We've got three units of Black Suns, and a bus for Pindo. It moves into base contact. Throw a bunch of dice at the bus. One frag grenade to give it surge crit. And six going into the bus. And saves two, takes four. Bus is broken. The bus is damaged. The fleets have been put back in the bus. Yep. Now they're disembarking. And they're gonna see if they can't clean up a squad of Black Suns here.
right there. I'm going to shoot you.
All right, fleet shooting at the three-man squad over here behind the AT-AT body. Oh, we're actually on turn six here, guys. These two have been on a killer pace all day. And if it comes down to points destroyed, bus going, aim shooting into the bus. Spin two shields, roll one. Bus takes a wound. And it's broken. And is only allowed to make one new action. Mark two. Two crits coming in. And it looks like Adam got it at the end. With the bus dying a horrible, horrible explosion-y death. So that is Adam with a win on a 2-1 KP. The end of this game went really quick. So hang out with us for a little bit longer. Once this round is over, I'm going to turn everything over to Ryan for a bit so he can do painting awards. If there was painting awards, I don't really know. But we will be back at 8:45 tomorrow morning with round four and the TO briefing, as I'll have Ryan mic'd up and standing a little closer for this one today or tomorrow. I do want to thank all of our people who participated on stream today, and each and every one of y'all that's hung out with us in chat and suffered through all of our minor technical difficulties, including multiple OBS crashes. We'll see what I can do to work on this evening at some point in time. But we are going to go hang out at the brew house, and we're going to enjoy some nice German food and brews. If you're in town and watching, come hang out with us. And tune in next week as we'll be streaming from Gigabytes Cafe in Marietta, Georgia, for their 32-person store championships. Looks like that one's going to be an exciting one. Lots of good players hang out down there in Atlanta, not to mention all those who are willing to travel. June 10th, Knoxville at Comics City 2. There's a little 12-man event getting together. We're gonna have an absolute blast. And on June 17th, Epico's Cards and Games in Chattanooga, Tennessee, store championship. We're currently limited to 16. If you're anywhere close to the area and want to come enjoy a chance at a World's Invite, we have some of the top players in the country going to be there. Chris Beezer's possibly making an appearance. And let's see what else we got going on. June 17th there. June 24th. We got the Outpost Desert Raiders Store Championship. And I believe this is in Johnson City. We're going to have an absolute blast with it. I'm going to take the mini captain, and we're going to see just how much damage we can do. What else? I know I'm missing something here. August 12th, Dice Head Games Store Championship. $10 entry fee, limited to 16 players. All your favorite rules and 800-point armies will be in effect. I very well may possibly be streaming that one as well. I will have a live stream going on June 17th with the player audio only, as I am the TO and judge. Now, I could commentate a little here and there throughout the day as we go, but I'm trying to find some information here. All right. Yep. There's that. We'll go ahead and get signed up for the Theater of War over at the 615 Legion. Got that one taken care of. Don't forget Invader League signups coming in June. First round scheduled to go off in July. Go ahead and sign up and get everything going and ready. And let's see. This game ended a little quicker, but these guys was on point and on a pace. Early it looked in Hendo's favor, but boy did it swing as the game went on. And I think, you know, anybody want me to flip the camera and swap a different table onto stream here while we got a few minutes? Let's see here. This is table 5. Who would it be? Who is it on table 5? Uh-oh. Thank you. table 5. Joel DeMeester and Joel DeMeester and David Jones. So tell you what, I'm going to swap the camera around here. Now, I do apologize. I don't know what objectives and stuff they're playing, and commentary will be kind of limited, but we'll see what we can make happen here.